So it's a beautiful sunny day here in Halifax, -8, -9 degrees. We're expecting a storm tomorrow night. Needed to get out today before I lost the opportunity. Barely a cloud in the sky. Seriously, beautiful. But Nova Scotia weather. A week and a half ago, we had 3 feet or 30 some centimeters, or closer to 100 centimeters of snow on the ground. Between the warm temperatures and the rain, we lost most of that. Actually, we lost all of it. And then we just got dusted in the last few nights, and we have maybe a half an inch on the ground. A little bit more in the shadowed places in the woods, but otherwise, very little snow. A little icy, but very little snow. So I'm going to come out and I'm going to make myself a fire today, and I wanted to try something. I've done it before, but I wanted to show you something and just have a little discussion on it. Since it is a beautiful sunny day, why not harvest the power of the sun to start our fire? So I carry in my fire kit a magnifying glass, and I'm going to give some close-ups of these in a few minutes. And this is a 5-power glass magnifying glass that I bought at Dollarama here in Halifax. I think it's $1.75 new right now. And I just cut the handle off, made a little holder for it to put it in. And I carry this in my larger fire kit, and I've always got it with me. And I use it quite often because it's actually quite rewarding being able to start a fire from the sun. But I thought, there's a few other things around. I have a small bag here I'm going to show you. A few other things available that you can use. My smaller fire kits all have Frizzell lenses in them. And they're a 3-power lens. And they're convenient to carry. They're not near as powerful as that 5-power glass magnifying lens, but they do work. The glasses I wear around my neck. I've started the fire with those. I don't do that all the time. I always have my glasses, but, you know, it will work. It's a little bit more challenging, but it does work. This is something I've done before. Now, this is be more of a survival trick, I guess, if you will, than something that I would carry on a regular basis. It's the reflector from an old D-cell flashlight that would have the incandescent bulb. Not one of the new LED flashlights, but one of the older style. And just for fun, I've done it before and I'll demonstrate it again. You can start a fire with these. You'll need the right material and place it in the right point on the lens, but you can start a fire with that. And I found something recently on eBay. Is it a gimmick? Yeah, I think it is. But it was, I thought I'd give it a shot. It was only a dollar. A solar cigarette lighter. I'll bring it in close so you can see. So there's a little spring-loaded curly Q there, and it's precisely measured that if you put a cigarette into the holder, aim it properly into the sun, it will harness the power of the sun very quickly, and it's set right at the apex, and it does start things burning. Actually, I tried it with a piece of char cloth, and the moment I turned it to the sun, the thing started smoking. It lit up right away, so I'll probably show that again as well. Is it a gimmick? Yeah, I'm sure it is. It stores away pretty flat. But I just wanted to give you an example of things that are available and the fact that you can use a lot of things. Now, I know that other people have tried and I have been successful in doing it as well. I'm not going to bother with it today. Using the old sandwich bag, fill it full of water, get it as tight into a round ball as you can to make as clean a sphere as you can and magnify the sun through that. I've done that. It's a trick. If you had to do it, well, you could practice it. But it's not something I would carry with me just for that purpose. And what else have I tried? Well, yeah, the bottom of a pop can. The concave bottom of a pop can. I've seen people use chocolate. I used toothpaste. It did the same job. Just polished it with my finger until I got it as mirror-like as I could. That took a bit of time because that's a small diameter concave reflector that it took a while to get the exact focus. And it was in the summertime. Here it is, March 13th, I believe, and you know, the sun is much stronger than it was mid-winter, but it's not as strong as it would be in mid-summer here in Nova Scotia, so I'm not going to try those things. They are tricks that are worth giving a shot just to prove to yourself that you can do them, like this. It's more of a trick to see if it would work, but a magnifying lens Is that a legitimate thing to carry with you? Yes. Yes, I believe it is. It is something that, why utilize resources that are non-renewable, like even your ferrocerium rod, maybe 1,000 strikes in it, but if you don't have it or if you don't want to waste the ferrocerium rod, why not use a magnifying lens on a beautiful day like this? So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to start a fire with a magnifying lens. Okay, try to find myself a spot that I'm not actually standing in my own light. I have some charred punk wood here. Something that I made right here in this spot a few months ago. And I'm doing this a little bit backwards, but let's just see. Holy smokes, that's it. Lit, just like that. Woo! Okay, so what I have is my solar reflector. The one I bought on eBay, it's a solar cigarette lighter. And right in the focal point, I have a tiny piece of char cloth. And what I have found is that it's very difficult to get the char cloth out of that little coil once it's lit. So it's better to use a small piece and then transfer the heat of the coal or the ember from that onto another piece of char cloth. So I'll back up and we'll just see how quickly this will light up once I face it into the sun. Okay, Frizzell lens, tiny piece of char cloth, won't be able to hold on to it very long. Find the focal point. Where's my sun? Oh, there it is. Might be able to see it easier from this side. There we go. All right, so this time what I have is the char cloth in a tiny split of stick, and I've just inserted it down inside of the flashlight reflector, and I'll back up and get some sun, see if I can't find the focal point for that. Go. Just a matter of getting in deep enough to the focal point. Okay, so far I have lit punk wood with my magnifying glass. I've lit char cloth with the solar cigarette lighter. I've used a Frizzell lens and I've used the reflector from a flashlight. So I'm back to my magnifying glass because this time, rather than use something that's charred, I'm going to use something found naturally in the wild. If you're lucky enough to find it, that is, which is chaga. So this is a nice little piece of dry chaga that I carry on my fire kit. I'm gonna get an ember going on this, and I've got a tinder bundle ready, which I will show you and blow it into flames, and then we'll get some fire on for lunch. All right, let's give this a go. So already I have smoke coming out of my chaga. I'm going to advance it a little further just by giving the ember a good head start. Probably not necessary, it just speeds it up a little bit. You may not be able to see the red. Okay, I'm going to transfer that into a tinder bundle and we'll get a fire started. So the nice thing when you're working with piece of chaga like that, it takes a bit of time for the coal to grow. But the whole time it's growing, it's producing more and more heat, which means if your materials that you're going to use in your tinder bundle are a little suspect, then this will help to dry them out. So what I've gathered together is some bracken, some beech leaves, some birch bark, some pine needles, things that I knew to be dry from around this immediate area. And I have some very fine spruce branches to hold it all together in. And I will set it right in the center of the driest material. And this is not as fast as if you're working with a nice little tinder bundle, but there is no rush. In fact, you can wave it while you a bit of a breeze happening, so I'm just going to let that do some of the work. And there we go. More than enough birch bark, so I'll just throw a piece on for safety. Smalls already. Some mediums. Wood is cold, so I'm going to start stacking it high. Okay, bring it back in a bit. Well, my lunch is cooking. And I'm just waiting to sit down and enjoy that. I thought I would just take this opportunity to thank you for watching my video and encourage you to get out and try solar ignition. Once you've done it, you'll probably look for an opportunity to do every time you're out. Easiest, best method that I found is the dollar store magnifying glass. It is real glass. It is a 5-power lens, less than $2 Canadian. Puts in your kit. It's there and available to you when you want it. So again, if you've enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And until next time, get out and explore. Take that path less traveled. It'll make all the difference. Bye for now.